around me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls, head to toe, designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist on the top.
Tonight, from MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, it's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Jets taking on the Detroit Lions.
We have a cold night in the Northeast. A bad evening to be without a parka, but we are set for football at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the New York Jets. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Jets ball club. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game. So they understand the importance of playing well and stopping this streak.
Meanwhile, for the Lions here, they've been as hot as anyone. The win last week makes it 9 out of 10.
The results are hard to argue. If there's a team better suited for the postseason right now, I don't know who they are.
The USC product, Sam Darnold, the number 3 overall pick in 2018, ready to go. Here's the Jets take over on offense.
And no excitement, unless you're on the defensive team of last week, in his numbers. Because the only excitement he really generated was the one interception he threw.
Yeah, no touchdown passes.
Yeah, and his team wasn't real thrilled about that. And they lost the game. So, I know this week has been tough on him because he's been working hard. Fundamentals, footwork, finding the right targets. The bottom line, how do they get a win?
And a good job of just fighting through one tackle there to pick up about 3. Second down coming up. The numbers for Bell on the ground in the game last week. 13 carries, 62 yards.
They look like a team that really emphasized a running game in the offseason. They were going to build around it. Didn't matter if they were going to run gap scheme, power scheme, whatever. They've got a runner who finds yardage if you give him just a little bit of space.
And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. You mixed in a few of those, but most of the players are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down. So opening drive, third down, they complete the slant to move the sticks.
And ordinarily, it's a high percentage pass when you throw it. And receivers like to run that route because it gets the ball in their hands pretty quickly. Just a couple of quick steps upfield, break towards the middle, the ball should be there, and then they can get to do some work afterwards.
On first down, Darnold. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. A gain of six there on first.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Darnold completes to Bell, and tackled down after a gain of three, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Here's the jet sweep to Pascal. And some space to move right away as he's hauled away up to the 30.
Well, I sure wouldn't be surprised if we see more of this as this game goes on, because we know they like to use their wideouts either on quick throws or on jet sweeps like what we just saw there. And to say that that one worked well, partner, that's stating the obvious.
Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
A gain of six there on first.
Brings up second and four at the 24-yard line.
Throwing again on second down. Darnold. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One-handed. Love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session. He'll be saying, hey, run that one back, coach. Yeah. Run that one back.
One more time.
Let's see that again.
One more time.
And they won't.
Eight more times.
They won't. Didn't get much out of it.
So on is Matt Prater now to try a field goal here. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this will remain a scoreless game. So out now come the Lions.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy, because normally from this range, about two out of three, and this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over, and it's a big kick, but now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong, because they have plenty of leg.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 10 carries, 134 yards.
He's having a nice season, and he knows where he ranks in the league. Don't ever let a running back tell you that they don't know that. They do. So what he's doing now is lobbying the offensive coordinator all week long. Hey, how about a few more touches? He's one big game away from maybe leading the league.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Here's There's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
9 yards. First down, Lions.
Running is Swift. And he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 29-yard line.
It's a gain.
A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Get this one down to about the 27. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Davis on the tackle. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Back to the running game with Swift. And he's going to get this down close to a first at about the Jets' 21. It's a gain of six. Moves him to a manageable third and two situation.
6 yards. And it's third down.
They'll try and run here with Swift. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
First down, Lyon.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And just a couple yards there down to the 17. And not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense column.
And they corralled him just a couple yards shy of the end zone.
Complete to T.J. Hockenson.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
From the two, here's first and goal. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. A 2 yard touchdown grab as his guys are on the board first here tonight. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
First down 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Back on the field come the New York Jets for their second drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, come and get a little bit closer
get
this
a little
time.
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay,
where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throwing deep for Galladay. And this is taken in at the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. That one good for 37 yards.
Well, he's definitely a big target out there, listed as 6'4", and he used every one of those extra inches to go up and make that catch.
Here's Swift. And he gets halfway there from the four to the two on a gain of two.
DeAndre Swift.
Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches just say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
This Jet defense so far standing tall. They need another stop now, third and... And this time he is in.
Yes.
DeAndre Swift with his 16th touchdown of the year. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, he can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Gonzalez to add the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drive, four plays. And it ends with a one-yard touchdown run.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this carries into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Another try after the first down sack. Darnold. Desmond King there on the coverage.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25. Now a timeout called for by the defense. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann.
For the Jets.
He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Fielded at the 20.
The Lions.
So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Lions will take over. The Lions offense set to take over. And let's look at their passing game, more specifically their receiving game. These guys have been great at wide.
I'm with you on that one. We'll look at it and we'll enjoy it and actually marvel at it. These guys are making every catch possible. Boy, have they been fun to watch in this game.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The sack by Jordan Willis.
The quarterback sack. A loss of 13 yards. It's second down.
So we come upon halftime with our score 14-0 as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll begin up at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, where it was the visiting Bears who come in and get the victory on the road. Mitchell Trubisky, excellent in the victory, as it's one that pushes his guys two games above 500. Next, we head off to check out another game, and they were winners in that one over the visiting LA Chargers. 28-17, your final score. And finally, on Monday Night Football, we'll wrap up the weekend with a good one between the Arizona Cardinals and the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Now this will make it into the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
They're on 21-yard line.
The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. And they'll try the jet sweep here. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
It's a gain of six. And the Lions first down.
From the gun, here's Swift. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That good for 19 and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
First down, he'll drop to throw it. Throwing deep for Galladay. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
It's now second and 10.
They run out of the gun with Swift. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Complete to Quintez Cephas.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. So from the 36 now, first and 10. throw here out of the gun. Open man is Galladay, complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
Here's the option.
And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and just keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
The 22-yard line.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
They'll stay on the ground with Swift.
DeAndre Swift.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense can look tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
A gain of a yard. It's now fourth down.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Kenny Galladay hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Lions add on to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now, starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Makes the score.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And that makes the score 21 to zip.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25.
So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2.
The shotgun snap for Darnold. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Dennis is incomplete.
The Jets try it, but the fourth down play doesn't work. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's Swift. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of 4.
Well, that's a pretty good drive starter right there. And I don't know, partner, if you're even thinking about sitting on the ball right now. They may just want to run their regular offense.
In plus territory, and as an offensive coordinator, you don't want your team to go into a shell, do you?
No, you really don't, because as soon as you take your foot off the gas, it's real hard to put it back on and mash it, because once everyone's emotions come down, hard to start them up again. So I think you may want to keep them cranking high right here.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
They'll run with Swift. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there. And now second down.
Well, if this defense has any hopes of getting back into this game, they've got to start right here and keep these guys out of the end zone. That's a good step one on that play.
From back at the 4, here's second and goal. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
On third and goal, they're going to run the option.
And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. It's their quarterback taking it in. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
Partner, wasn't that long ago that when I talked with these NFL coaches about different innovations in the college game, you can see their eyes roll and they just shut down right away. Don't bring me that Joe College stuff. Well, guess what? The college game has definitely infiltrated its way into the NFL.
Yeah, and these guys, when you're seeing the option defensively, you got to stick to your assignments. I know that's cliche. They didn't do it there.
And option football means exactly what you just talked about, assignment football for defenders. And that drives them crazy because you have to think your way through a play as opposed to just reacting and making the play.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
New York ready to go again offensively. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun, and he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Darnold from the gun. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Bell. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Darnold on first down. A good throw here, finding Pascal. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. From the 50, it's Darnold. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Romeo Okwara able to record his fifth sack of the season.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
On fourth down, Darnold. He finds his target. It's Crowder. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. He's got Burton here.
That's
a gain of six there on first. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. This one into the hands of Burton. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
It's just me and you.
56. Mike, 56. Right there, right there.
Again, Darnold. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one at the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Are you, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. For the point after. He's got it to bring it back to 28-7 now. A 10-play drive that time. And it's finished off by a New York Jets touchdown. Now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Now Norwood. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
First and 10 at their own.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. That one looks like he'll throw here. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left.
For T.J. Hawkinson, incomplete.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. He's going to let it go again. That's caught inside the 20. And DP goes into Jets territory before being taken down. A big connection on that one. 55 yards. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more little insult to injury here late in the game. This will be a 34-yard attempt. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So for the Lions, they continue to keep pace for that first round bye as they move to 11-1. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to the Windy City to take on the Bears. Meanwhile, for the Jets, the playoffs look to be out of reach now as they drop to 4-8. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the Cleveland Browns. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden, alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
T-Rag got me.
Hey, boy, and be some. You gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check.